Instagram. Today we are standing in front of the all new facelifted 2019 Baleno. This is finished in a nice cream color. Here are the smoked out headlamps with the Xenon projector headlamp and the indicator over here with this nice daytime running LED over here. Here we have the fog lamps with this nice chrome garnish, the honeycomb grill with the chrome garnish at the up and down. Here is this nice, what I said, this sporty kind of a bumper to the car. And here is the key fob. By like removing this, you get the key. So here is the key fob, and you can unlock the vehicle by the key fob or with the help of the request sensors on the door. Here are the side mirrors, they are body colored. Here you get the chrome finish on the mirror borderline. You get the door protectors over here with the chrome garnish. Here we have Goodyear Assurance 195/55 R16, same as the Baleno as we have seen in the past video. Here is the chrome door handles, and you have this the sun protector or like the rain deflector. This is a DDIS diesel which is powered by a 1.3 liter multi-jet diesel motor. Here are the LED tail lamps which are partial. You get half on this, half on the tailgate and half on the body. Here you have the parking sensors, there are four, with the reflector completed with this chrome garnish with rear bumper. Here is the smart hybrid technology which you are driving. And here's the chrome finish on the rear trunk lid with the badging of the vehicle. Here you can open the boot with the help of the key fob. And or you have a request sensor over here by which we open the lid. Here are the lights for the number plate. Here is the rear parking camera. Here is the chase is approximately like 550 liters or something like that. Here is a light underneath to illuminate the boot when it's night. Here is the spare wheel with the toolkit. I think it's a same 15 inch spare wheel as you get on the Baleno. Here is the insulation. So now we can unlock the vehicle in two ways, via this button on the keyboard or with the help of request sensor on the car. On to the door pad. Here we have the leather damping on the doors to get a comfortable position. Here we have the wood finish, nice wood finish with this silver outline going over here. We also have the wood finish on the door. We have four power windows, and by the way, this is the top end alpha variant. Here we have the the automatic driver side window, and all the rest are normal. Here you have the button to fold or unfold the outside rear view mirrors and the controls to adjust the outside rear view mirrors. So guys, now we are in the interior of the car. Here is the central screen. Here is the the push button start, and here we roar into life. We have ambient lighting inside the the dials, and here is the fuel gauge, the speedometer, the tachometer, and the engine temperature meter. You have a warning saying that fuel low and all. It shows all the warnings and other features as you have seen in the Baleno. So that's that, and here you have the automatic climate control of the car. Okay, then here we have the touchscreen system from Maruti Suzuki. Like, you have the contacts and all over here, and the smartphone connection like the Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. The navigation over here, you get a SD card that you need to insert over here, and the radio, you can adjust the volume from here. You can mute it from here, and the hazard lights are over here. The AC vents are very nicely placed. You also have a cubby hole over here where you can like keep your keys. keep your keys over there, and you have some what we say, some switches over here. You have a cruise control in this vehicle. Because it is a top end variant, you also have the cruise control on this car. Here are the other modes, here are the other voice commands and all. Here are the voice commands and other features that you can have. And yeah, now let's move on to the rear seats. Yeah. Here we get the leather seats in the Sias. You don't need any seat covers for this. These are very comfortable, and you have seat height adjustment over here, and the what we say, the recliner and other settings over here. Now let's move on to the back seat. So now we are inside the vehicle. Here are the rear AC vents, and you also get a 12 volt power socket over here. You get some space to keep some papers or something. You get nice leg room when it's at the front, and you also have good leg room when the seat is pushed totally backwards. And now let me show you the rear armrest. It has two cubby holes over here, and the armrest to keep your hand, like, to be very comfortable. And you get inbuilt rear sunshades over there, and you get this headrest, and you also have a sunshade over here which is factory fitted. Here is this, and here we have the door pads. Here also you get the same wood finish with the silver trim, with the same wood finish over here. You get the door handles in chrome. Here you have a space to keep some knickknacks and a bottle over here. Now let's move on to the front door part. Here you have nice space to keep the knickknacks and the bottle over here. You get the carpeted floor. You also get the floor mats which are kept in the boot rack. And now let's move on to the engine. Now here is the 1.3 liter DDIS multi-jet diesel engine. Here is the engine bay. Here you have the battery, the radiator coolant, and the fuse box over there with the projector headlamps and the washing fluid over here. The SH3S technology, it produces more, it gives the more mileage to the car with keeping less load on the engine. These are the features of the car. Wow. So thank you guys for subscribing to the channel. Please subscribe, like, share, and please subscribe to the channel.